Welcome to this week's White House History Weekly. August 24, 1814, saw the burning of the White House by British troops. They had advanced on Washington and burned the United States Capitol, and then went to the White House where they set it afire, losing most of the building. It took 3 years to rebuild. Today, our historian, Dr. Matthew Costello, is going to tell us more about that fire, its role in White House history, and the rebuilding of the White House.
Thank you, Stuart. August 24th, 1814 marks one of the darkest days in the history of the White House. It was on that day that an invading British force marched on the nation's capital and set fire to the President's house, along with the U.S. Capitol building, the Treasury building, and the executive offices. The Capitol building was burned first, and then the British marched down Pennsylvania Avenue to burn the President's house, the executive offices, and the Treasury building. What most people don't know is that this was actually a retaliatory response. A year earlier, an invading American force had moved into Upper Canada and burned their capital city, York. Today we know it as Toronto. But with the Napoleonic Wars over in Europe, the British could turn their full attention to the former colonies, and they decided to make a point by destroying the new federal city, which had only been moved as the seat of government 14 years earlier. The White House is the most iconic building in the United States, and to see it engulfed in flames was a pretty demoralizing event. To lose these very important symbols of the new country's power, its institutions, was quite devastating. But the best course of action then, to remedy that, was to rebuild. Now, there was, of course, debate about whether or not Congress and the federal government should move elsewhere. Should it return to a city like New York, Philadelphia, Boston, Baltimore? Or perhaps it should move further westward, because that appeared to be the direction that the country was headed. But support was coalesced around James Madison and his supporters keeping the capital in Washington, D.C. And on the heels of ratifying the Treaty of Ghent, ending the War of 1812, Congress was able to appropriate money to repair and rebuild the buildings of the nation's capital. Among them was the President's House. James Hoban, the Irish-born architect who had originally constructed the house during the 1790s, was brought back by the commissioners to rebuild it between 1814 and 1817. The fire essentially gutted the building. It destroyed a lot of the interior, and on such a short work schedule, Hoban had to decide to use wood primarily for the interior skeleton of the building. Now, even though the next president, James Monroe, moved in that fall in 1817, there was still quite a bit of work to be done. Hoban would eventually come back later to add the south portico in 1824 and the north portico in 1829-1830.